introducing is males should have higher characteristics than females. A male, a man or a boy, should, to express duty or obligation, have, to hold in one's keep or in one's possession, hire, over or above, car, an automobile, insurance, the act or process of insuring property or a person, land, in comparison with females, a woman or a girl. There are many reasons why males should have higher than females. My colleagues will mention a few. Males are proven to have more accidents per year, which means why should females pay for the damage done by males? Girls are more careful when they are driving because they take their time to get from point A to point B. There should be no argument about this if males didn't ruin it on themselves. I'm not saying that this refers to all males, but because some males can be careful at times, but the majority of males do drive faster than females. From these few reasons I've mentioned, you will now have to agree with me before you even hear my colleagues that males should have higher car insurance than females. Thank you.
Thank the Prime Minister for her remarks. Yes. We shall now hear from the first speaker of the opposition. If the opposition wishes to contest the government definition of terms or introduce a counterclaim, it must do so during this address.
Good afternoon, Madam, Mr. Chairperson. Be it resolved that males should pay a higher price for car insurance than females. It's not fair for guys who just got their license and they have to pay for their own car insurance. It costs them hundreds of dollars, and for girls it's just a couple of dollars. And that's no problem to get that kind of money together. But it's different though for guys who have to borrow, pay half, or spend their savings of hundreds of dollars. Another point is guys and girls will be driving a car, truck, or a van, and both will have an equal chance of getting in an accident. So why pay higher insurance rates for a guy? My final point is, this is discrimination against males. You shouldn't have to penalize all males because of what other males have done. I think not, Madam, Mr.
Thank you. I now call on the second government speaker, who must completely describe the plan for implementing the bill.
Good afternoon, Mr. Speaker, the opponents, and members of the House. We are here to discuss the bill that says that males should definitely pay higher car insurance rates. My first out of many reasons to help urge you also to believe this as firmly as I do is that males often drive recklessly, trying to impress their friends or girlfriends, but most refined, serene girls do not. It's natural and biological for guys to show off more in cars, while girls are much more civilized and careful. When the designated driver is a girl, they are more apt to keep their promise not to drink than a guy who is easily distracted by temptation. Guys tend to drive faster and get in more accidents because they're always looking for attention. If you recall the book Hot Rod, Walt was always driving crazily and he got most of his friends killed. Although it was based on fiction, it should teach a lesson. Males are always with a carload and then have another chance to show their driving ability. With all my reasons, plus the first speaker's reason, the Prime Minister, you should well by now agree that males are too reckless and should and must pay higher car insurance rates. Even if you are a male yourself. But remember, if it were to change, your insurance wouldn't go down, just the girls would go up. It would only make your parents go to the courthouse.
Thank you, second speaker. I now call on the second speaker for the opposition.
Cross, that's not up to you. It's up to these six. You don't do a thing. I just got them started. I was to get them started, not you. I don't have to get you started.
Mr. Speaker, for the opponents in this standing, the bill being presented at the House today is men should have a higher car insurance than women. I firmly believe that men
men should definitely not have to pay higher car insurance than females. Because for one thing, expanding on Peggy's statement, people are discriminating against the males. They say men are reckless and get in many accidents for the same reasons as guys, and are just as reckless a lot of the time. Secondly, why should a male be expected to pay more for car insurance when a lot of the time they have less money? Girls and women, if they don't have a job, save up money and babysitting their insurance because their insurance costs much less than a guy. Where a guy who doesn't babysit often maybe can't find a job, so his parents have to pay for his expenses. Poor boys, for example, shouldn't have to pay all the extra money and parents of poor girls. Especially when boys' car insurance costs approximately $200 more than girls. The car insurance company doesn't have to pay any more to get a male's car fixed than a female's car when they have smashed an automobile. Once again, I ask why a male's car insurance is higher than a female's.
Thank you, Second Speaker, for your remarks. I now call upon the third government speaker to deliver the final speech in support of the bill.
Mr. Speaker, worthy opponents and members of the House, as you already know, the bill that we are presenting is whether or not males should have higher car insurance. This is definitely true. Besides, they have no equal rights for anything else, so why should they be for this? Males always have a higher standard of living, so why can't they have higher car insurance? Even though car insurance is higher for guys under the age of 21, it's equal from then on. I firmly believe that it should be higher throughout a guy's life. It's like when you buy something of one brand, why switch over to another?
Better.
Now I am going to summarize some of the facts that my colleagues have stated. The first speaker, Madam Prime Minister, had many facts to shoot down our opponents. First, she said that males have more accidents per year, and that's a fact. She also said that girls are more careful drivers. Definitely true. Also, we wouldn't be debating this topic if males didn't ruin it on themselves and then drive so recklessly. Second speaker, Donna McCaffrey, also had many good reasons. Most guys tend to show off more in cars than girls do. Girls are usually the designated driver and are not easily distracted by liquors. Also, girls, when driving, usually bring along a good crowd, so therefore they tend to show off more. Now, from hearing my reasons, along with my colleagues' reasons, I'm sure that now you will agree with us and are thoroughly convinced that males should have paid more for car insurance.
Nope.
Yeah.
Nope.
Thank you, Leader of the Opposition. Thank you. Leader of the Opposition will now deliver the last speech opening the question of the bill. It is her responsibility to complete the attack on the government case to defend and summarize the position of the opposition.
Mr. Speaker, Mrs. Downey, and worthy opponents, I would like to summarize for you what my colleagues have now just stated. First of all, can you actually sit there and think that it is fair for men who have just got their license to pay such a large sum of money for their insurance?
Yeah.
No!
Don't you think you are wrong? Dead wrong. Yeah. This is a clear case of discrimination against the male sex.
Yeah!
You should not penalize
children were finished school and on their own.
It'll be worse if it was with girls.
shouldn't even be here today to debate it.
Here, here.
Please don't ask yourself.
I thank the leader of the opposition and now call on the Prime Minister to prevent the government official rebuttal.
Mr. Chairperson, fellow colleagues for the opposition, as the first person said, that women should go out and get a job. Why can't males go out and get a job?
And they do.
Yeah.
And guys have ruined on themselves anyway. And you were saying that all guys, that not all guys are reckless drivers, as I stated they are. But it's proven fact that
yeah,
guys,
there's more accidents. That girls have accidents too.
And reckless drivers.
Yeah,
and
reckless drivers.
And as the third person said, that we wouldn't have to be here right now because it's such an absurd bill. But as I said at first, guys have ruined on themselves.
Well, they did, and so did girls.
People just discriminate against them.
Yeah, discrimination.
It's a proven fact that men get more accidents.
Yeah, there's more males.
Guys really have more chance of getting a job because of males.
No, they wouldn't, because it's equal opportunity.
And it is not discrimination. It is pure. It's a pure fact.
Has to be short. No sentence.
And first person, parents usually pay. I'm not saying all parents do, but if people don't have to get a job,
if their children do not
raise them, parents can help. And yeah, second person, it's a proven fact that men get in more accidents.
I thank the Prime Minister for concluding the debate. Would the clerk please collect the scorecards from the judges as soon as they have completed?
The score was
4-4.
I am pleased to welcome you to this third round of the 1989 Grade H Parliamentary Debate. The topic being debated today is Resolve. Athletes should be able to use steroids. On my right, representing the government, the Prime Minister, Dwayne Gillis, the second government speaker, Rossie McGuinness, the third government speaker, Corey McNeil. Speaking for Her Majesty's loyal opposition will be his first speaker, Michael McDonald, second opposition member, Jimmy Walker, and the leader of the opposition, Paul McGuinness. On behalf of the House, I extend a special welcome to our judges, Sean McMaster, Lisa McDonald, and Sean McNeil. The clerk, timer of the House will be Cindy McCarran and Amanda McKinnon, and I, Joy Ashford, am your speaker. Each debater will have 2 minutes in which to deliver his remarks. The Prime Minister's time will be divided between a 2-minute opening speech and a 2-minute official rebuttal. The clerk will indicate the speaking time by using the light system. 15 seconds grace will be allowed. I shall then immediately call upon the next debater to begin his address. Judges should not confer with one another until after they have scored the debate. As Speaker, I shall entertain points of order and personal privilege. Heckling will be allowed, though judges are to penalize any debater who interrupts another thoughtlessly or excessively. I call upon the Prime Minister to introduce the bill, define the terms, and outline the government case.
Madam Speaker, members of the opposition and members of the House, be it resolved that athletes should be allowed to use steroids. I'll now define the terms for today's debate as defined in the World Book Dictionary. Athletes, a person trained in exercises of physical strength, speed, and skill, especially one who competed in games using agility and stamina, should, to express duty or obligation, allowed, to be permitted, use, to put it into action or service. Steroids, a large class of structurally related compounds containing carbon or steroids. After you have heard what my partners and I have to say, I hope you agree that steroids should be allowed in sports. First of all, I think that steroids should be allowed in sports in order to compete competitively with other countries who are winning sports events by using steroids. Secondly, the argument is that steroids destroy the body. But have you ever heard a report of this actually happening?
Well,
so
no. It comes
yes.
later.
I do not. Even place. It's our bodies, and it's free of world. We should be allowed to do what we want with this.
Of course we should.
Yeah.
Gee, yeah.
Athletes get many more injuries than the ordinary person. They should have steroids as an aid to get their strength.
Yeah.
Lastly, professional sports, although it's called sports, is really a business. This is how they make their living. Professional sports is different than amateur sports, where people do it just for the fun of it. In a business, you do what you have to do to win, which includes using steroids.
Cheating.
I thank the Prime Minister for his remarks. We shall now hear from the first speaker of the opposition. If the opposition wishes to contest the government definition of terms or introduce a counter plan, it must do so during this address.
Opponents and members of the House. Be it resolved that athletes should be allowed to use steroids.
Never.
I will now define the terms for today's debate as defined in the World Book Dictionary. Athlete, a person trained and exercised in physical strength, speed, and skill, especially one who competes in games using agility and stamina, not steroids. Allowed, to be permitted, used, to put into action or service. Steroids, a large class of structurally related compounds, containing the carbon ring of sterols. In the next short while, my colleagues and I will prove to every member of the House that athletes should not be allowed to use steroids.
They should, sir.
To me, using steroids in sports is completely ludicrous.
That's all.
It's you, one person.
Sports are supposed to test how well an athlete can perform, not how well he or she can cheat. Steroids are only used by greedy people who know they can't win on their own strength. Disgraced runner Ben Johnson is no exception. As his coach Charlie Francis revealed, Johnson was using steroids when he set the 100-meter record in Rome in 1987.
How fast he went.
The money was using steroids. That's why he went so fast.
The money he made.
And even though he tried to deny it, he was using steroids in the 1988 Olympics in Seoul. Many people would have been prouder of him if he got a bronze medal, not using steroids, and when he won,
only by cheating.
The International Track and Field Association did the right thing in 1974 by banning steroid use from any track and field.
No way!
But greedy as man is today, he'll stoop that low to win. My last point today is that steroids cause kidney damage as well as cancer and cirrhosis of the liver.
It's never been proven.
Athletes know this, but again, in their greed to win, they don't concern themselves with the risks involved in taking steroids. So after hearing this and what my colleagues are about to say, you will definitely agree that steroids should not be allowed to be used by athletes.
No way.
Yes, no.
Thank you. I now call on the second government speaker, who must completely describe the plan for implementing the bill.
Members of the House, you have to agree with us that steroids should be allowed to use.
Yeah.
Sure, everybody likes to watch a good race on TV. If all the athletes took steroids, all the races would be a lot closer.
Yeah, that's cheating.
I mean, if people don't want to take steroids and reduce their chances of winning, they don't have to.
It's supposed to be a natural
event. A recent poll done on TV said that 87% of Canadians said that athletes caught using steroids should be allowed to compete in other sports.
Where was that survey taken, internet?
If you think steroids are really that bad and have such a health problem, look at Ben Johnson. He has been taking steroids for quite some time. And last year, he broke his own record.
That's because they boost your strength.
So we can't have that
exactly.
much of a health
We're,
problem
yeah, right.
if he can run that fast. And look at Angela Jinks. She was ranked fourth in the world only because she was taking steroids.
That's right. She cheated.
Yes.
Thank you. I now call on the second speaker for the opposition.
Good afternoon, Madam Speaker, Prime Minister, and Member of the House. French. Today, as you know, me and my fellow colleagues are debating steroids should not and I repeat, should not be allowed in sports.
It should.
If you hear my reasons, I think you will also agree.
No, we won't.
No, we won't.
First of all, unfairness.
Very
some
not.
Of them take no. them, some of them don't.
Not at all.
What do you call it? You know, maybe most of them.
Sure, sure. We all know steroids do help athletes.
Of course,
right. Of course they do.
But it's not winning yourself.
Yes, it is.
Who's doing it?
Natural ability.
You're doing it.
We all know the people who are caught in using steroids are banned in sports. Like Ben Johnson. He is no exception. People who take steroids are definitely cheaters. They only take them so they can win.
Right.
Without them, they would be nowhere. Do all those people like cheating?
Yeah,
secondly,
of course.
Steroids are very dangerous. They affect your brain, your heart, and many other organs in your body.
There's no case of that.
When you first start steroids, it takes you from every bit of your body. You become a person becomes very thin.
They don't become thin.
You will eventually obtain larger muscles,
yeah, where's
but
that?
It takes
what
time.
Away?
Steroids also stretches arteries and veins, and they begin to bulge.
Did
infections
you ever hear that
to
anybody?
Thank you.
Happens in later years.
Not right yet.
It's suspected to happen in order.
Never happened.
Short.
Thank you for your remarks. I now call on the third government speaker to deliver the final constructive speech in support of the bill.
Madam Speaker, worthy opponents, and members of the House, I hope you will vote for us to pass this bill. You are all probably watching the Dublin Inquiry.
Yeah.
At the Dublin Inquiry, it said that over 80% were using steroids.
Right, they're all cheaters.
Yeah, and
there's
some good ones.
Over 80% using steroids.
Every last one 80
is quite a large amount.
Yeah.
The other 20% are probably just some of the worst runners.
They're the most fair runners.
Yeah.
Around.
Yeah.
But if they were taking steroids, they would be competitive.
Right. That's just cheating.
Even if,
the
athletes would be allowed only a certain amount, it'd make the running more competitive.
Yeah.
I guess it would.
To summarize our points, as the Prime Minister said, other countries are using steroids and make Canada more competitive. We should too.
Yeah,
as the second,
we should. Cheaters.
As the second speaker said, we all like competitive races,
right.
And that's what would make the races more competitive.
Competitive by not cheating.
They make them more competitive.
Yeah.
Thank you. The leader of the opposition will now deliver the last speech opposing the bill. It is his responsibility to complete the attack on the government case and to defend and summarize the position of the opposition.
Madam Speaker and unworthy opponents. Steroids have become abused by athletes, hoping to improve their performance in various sports.
It does, it works.
By cheating. Yeah.
Cheating.
The drug increases muscle bulk and adds to the appetite for training, as well as, apparently, enhancing aggressive behavior.
They can't do it on their own stress.
Yeah.
What? You never cheat if you
in all sports, steroids should be banned. Not only because it is unfair
never.
To straight athletes, but it can also cause very serious side effects.
Didn't happen anywhere.
Never happened anyone yet.
They're out of the spotlight.
They may cause bad around your heart.
Have you ever seen